what you want, for real. We love you. Yeah. And you're a good man, too.
That's right.
You got a lot of patience.
Yeah.
And we love what y'all do. We really, 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 really do.
They told me that I was being honored with a Woman of the Year award. I was like, me? I felt like I just wanted the world to know who Remy, the person was. Not Remy Ma, not walk around metal detectors, not like just me. And I felt like that because I had been stripped of everything. I have no weave. I ain't have no eyelashes. These are the things you don't realize. You can't get a wax. You like a year in, you like, yo, it's crazy. But besides that, the most things that I care about, I was away from my son. I was away from my husband. I was away from my mom. I missed my son's elementary school graduation, his junior high school graduation, countless birthdays, Christmas, New Year's, Mother's Day, everything that you could think of. And I said, when I got out of there, that I was going to just be sat down and we said, we're gonna show people that black love is real. We're gonna show them that you can't, like, I had my son when I was really young. My husband had, you know, his children when he was really young. But we have a wonderful blended family. My son is 16, my stepson is 16, my stepdaughter is 20. She wears all my wigs and my makeup and my bags. I love her to death, but she's crazy. But we all live together. And somebody asked me today, and she said, how do you put up with it? Like, how do you know, with all the fame and this and that? And I said, that doesn't matter to me. I have a square. I don't have a circle anymore. I have a square. And this corner is me, because I got to make sure me is okay. We have to take care of us. I watched my grandmother, I watched my mother for years take care of everybody, but they never took care of themselves. You got to take care of you, so you can take care of others.
Yeah.
And this corner over here is my husband, who's never ever going anywhere. I'm not allowing him to. If he wants to, you're stuck. Still, you should have left when you had the chance. In this corner over here, it's my children, who is so amazing when I see my son say things like, you know, I'm tired of having all these girls. I just want to pick one that I can marry. Boy, you are 16. Not, but it's because he sees what's in the household. He sees the wedding pictures. He sees how we are there for each other. And that's something that we installed into me. It freaked me out a bit, but I was kind of happy about it. If I happen to be famous, great. If I happen to make some money, wonderful. If not, I'm going to still be okay because that square is going to stay the same.
Yeah.
It's not going to change. Diva, I would like to thank you for bringing me here, for allowing me to speak, for allowing me to show. Like, I am proof that you can go through anything.
Yeah.
Like, trust me, I've been through it all. Jail, did it. Prison, because it's different from jail, trust me. Did it. Loss of children, did it. Homelessness, did it. Parents with drugs. Every possible thing that you think could go wrong in your life, it happened to me. And I'm still here. And I'm healthy, and I'm happy, and I wake up every day, and I thank God that I'm here. And all of you have that same opportunity. It may be sometimes when you feel like this is the worst thing ever, you can't go another day. Trust me, I could not see the light at the end of the tunnel. No one could tell me 2 years ago, 3 years ago, that I'd be standing here giving a Woman of the Year acceptance speech. They just told me I can do it. Statistics say that I should be on public assistance, trying to get a job, and, you know, my man going in. You know, statistics lie, absolutely. So just don't be one of those number statistics. Set your own goals and just strive to be everything. Go all the way up.